What's up, guys? Today I am gonna be working on a truck, and I'm gonna be pulling out the front differential. As you can see, got my wheels off, got the truck on jack stands. Safety first, everybody. And you guys may be wondering why I'm taking off the front diff. It's because I'm gonna go back to a drive. And you may be asking, why would you go back to a drive? Because there's less parts to break, like the diff, axles, transfer case, and the transmission. And yeah. So let's get to it. I'm gonna make this quick. So we're gonna start by draining the differential. Looks kinda dirty. See? People don't think about changing their fluid or anything. Imagine if I kept that in there. Probably would have blown up my diff too. Next, I am going to remove this dust cap and loosen the axle nut inside, as well as disconnect the spindle from the lower control arm. Then I could pull off the whole spindle from the axle assembly, and then after that I can pop off the axles and do the same thing to the other side. To pull out the axle, the part where it goes inside the diff, I just used two pry bars and just pried it against the diff and push it out, and then just pull it out. So now we're gonna do the same exact thing to this side. And once you got both axles out, driver's side, passenger side, we will now unbolt the drive shaft bolts. So there's four of them. And a good practice is to mark the flange of your diff and your drive shaft prior to removing it. I know that's kind of ugly, but the reason for doing so is because the drive shaft is like balanced, and sometimes, well, I haven't experienced it, but sometimes when you put it back, and if you put it back like in a mismatched spot, you can get vibrations from it. So I always do that. I never did touch these drive shaft bolts ever since I converted this truck to four-wheel drive. So, it's been a while. And I think that was like maybe... It'll probably be... I think it's gonna make like 3 years this year already. Once the drive shaft bolts are out, you can grab your pry bar and just pry on it and it should disconnect just like that. So the drive shaft off the diff is off, and next step we are going to unbolt this one bolt right here for the back mount of the diff. And then the two in the front, and we'll be ready to pull this thing out. I put some rags, or well, the shop towels inside the ends of the diff because there's like a little bit of fluid still inside and it could leak out, so it can and it will get messy. And now we're gonna be removing the front diff mounts. So this is gonna be a size 22, and for the one, the rear diff mount, it's gonna be a size 12 hex, so like this, or socket, or a Allen socket, whatever. And then for, that's also the same size for the drain for the diff too, you guys were wondering. And you guys were probably wondering about this as well. So the reason why there is the diff spacer and washers is to correct the angle of the axles, because since I went higher with the shocks and the spacer on the shock, my axle angles were kind of steep again. But luckily the Rough Country kit utilizes the stock front diff mounts, so I was able to still add washers to drop the diff some more so it could correct the angles better. But I know the Fabtech kits don't use the stock front diff mounts, so that's a good thing about Rough Country. Good job, Rough Country. I'm gonna put the jack up to hold the diff for safety. So we got that out. And this part is gonna kind of be critical because the back mount has to like hop over the rear cross member and then kind of slide in between. So this part would be easier with an extra pair of hands, but it's just me today. So we're gonna try handle that. if anything happens to me, 911, that's the number you guys gotta call. Alrighty guys, so the front diff is officially out and there's a lot of room. But yeah. I'm just gonna leave the four-wheel drive transmission in because that's just too humbug to take out. So I'm just gonna leave it in. But yeah. Nah, just play with you guys. So the real reason why I put out the front diff is because I'm gonna go get my diffs re-geared. Finally, going to get it re-geared. So now I just gotta do the back. I haven't driven this truck in like since a week because you see that puddle right there. So my diff is leaking in the back. And I figure since I'm gonna get it re-geared, I'll just wait till I have to pull off the diff rather than like pulling it off and then resealing it, putting it back in, and then having to pull it off for like a week later or like a couple weeks later. So I've been using this to work and it's been going pretty good. Knock on wood. Hopefully nothing bad happens for life, because I'm done with 240 problems. There's like so much room now. It feels so empty. But I bet the truck must be lighter without all of that. So for the back, I'm gonna probably get it started in a bit, but my camera's about to die, so I probably won't vlog it. But it's kind of the same concept. So take off the wheel, put the axle on jack stands, and there's like four bolts holding the hub to the axle housing. Then you pull out the axles. So the axles are, there's like a shaft connected to the differential, which is also known as a third member. So you unbolt these guys, unbolt your brake lines, pull it maybe like 3 to 4 inches out for both sides, unbolt your drive shaft, and then unbolt your diff and pull it out. So yeah guys, I know the title can be a little misleading and it may seem like I am going back to two-wheel drive, but hey, I actually did pull out the front diff and the axles, which is pretty much the front four-wheel drive stuff. But that's pretty much the reason why I did so. So I'm excited for the re-gear and can't wait to send out my diffs and get it back and throw it back in the truck. Let's see if you guys can guess what gear ratio I went with for the truck. So comment down below on what you guys think I went with and we'll see if you guys are correct. So I guess that's pretty much it for this video. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Just want to say thank you to all the new subscribers that subscribe, and thank you to all of you who've been active watching our videos and commenting. So yeah guys, thanks for all your support. You guys already know the drill. Don't forget to like, comment, share our videos, and subscribe.